Good afternoon, everyone. We had a long trip coming to the U.S., so hello. Salam alaikum. Hola. Bonjour. Ni men hao. Ciao. Merhaba. So we wish you all welcome here to Northern Illinois University. We'll have intercultural orientation right now, so that you would know that what is good in your culture may be bad in another culture. We're switching between your culture and the U.S. culture. We want you to be empowered so you know what to do. Cultural shock, you go through three stages: sweet dreams, lover's quarrel, and bittersweet. So three stages of your life will be here at Northern in one semester: honeymoon, cultural shock, adjustment, and mastery. Then when you go home, you'll have honeymoon, re-entry shock, recovery, and then you have to readjust. So you'll be swinging up and down. You'll feel, 这里的锅贴为什么不好吃? Why is the croissant here does not contain butter? Why is the coffee here taste like juice of your dirty socks? Because it's different from what you have at home. But then later you realize the biryani here is really more meaty than the vegetarian biryani you're used to at home. So there will be some mood changes that you go through. What are cultures different? Because each society is different. Each society goes through different historical changes. Each society has its own economy, culture, religions. There are poor people, there are rich people, there are different cultures. And there are people who live in the city, there are people who live in the countryside, there are people who are living in the suburbs. All of these lead to diversity, even within the U.S. There's the lost generation, GI generation, silent generation, the baby boomers, generation X, Y, and Z. All of them have different subcultures. Many people in other countries look at the past. Americans look at the present and the future. But who are the Americans? There's the European American, Native American, Latinos and Latinas, African American, Asian American, and mixed people of mixed heritage. There are old rich, new rich, middle class, old poor, and a lot of new poor. But the white Anglo-Saxon Protestants are members of the dominant group. There's traditional nuclear family, there's single parent family, there are gay couples, and one out of three are never married single individuals. There are about 2 million people who are over 90 years old. And senior citizens are happy to be alone. There's preppy, juff, punk, scant, reggaeton, eco-friendly, the Guido, Guidette, the skater subcultures. It's not a question of right and wrong. We just have different cultures. What are the contending values? Americans tend to be more individualistic. In other societies, people tend to be more communitarian. Americans are very competitive. Other societies are more cooperative. Americans want direct answers. In some societies, you have to wait 20 minutes to get an answer. How do we behave in terms of non-verbal communication? Many foreign currencies, or MAP, whatever, are in full color. Rupees, rupia. But if you look at the US dollar, it's all green. So be careful when you give $100 bill, tell them, this is $100, I need change. Americans see themselves as in the middle of the universe. Other cultures are just a small dot in the universe. We greet people differently. And when Americans see each other, they meet one by one. Other cultures, the whole group meets. In other cultures, you are only polite to the rich and famous. In the U.S., you have to be polite to everyone. In other cultures, we always touch each other. In the U.S., you need personal space. Don't touch people, not in the elevator or when you fall in line. In the U.S., firm handshake is very important. In other societies, women don't touch men's hands. In the U.S., you have to be friendly to everyone. And other people in other cultures take pictures. Americans tend to just watch. Americans eat cold meals like salad and sandwich and cereals. People in other cultures have hot food all the time. Americans love ice. Other cultures love chai, he cha, or, and in the U.S., you're not supposed to burp or to fart publicly. Americans are very hospitable, but by appointment only. They want their privacy. Don't gossip around. When they say Q, then you have to fall in line. Don't mess around. And in the US, people want to be dark. In many societies, people want to be white. American professors could be very formal. They could wear blue jeans. And blowing nose is very rude in some societies. In the US, you see it very often. In other societies, you can smoke as you wish. In the US, you cannot. You have to be 18 years old and you need an ID. And it's rude to be late in the US. In other cultures, it's rude to be early. Okay? It's rude not to open the gifts in front of Americans here. In other cultures, it's rude to open the gifts. The way they sit here, it's rude in some cultures, not in the US. Eye contact is important in the US, and it's rude in other cultures. Staring at somebody's okay in other cultures, not in the US. And in other cultures, you need two hands to give your business card, not in the US. Thumbs up is okay in the US, not in Argentina. It's very rude. And using the left hand is bad in other cultures, it's okay in the US. And it's rude to point the finger at other cultures, not in the US. Visa is rude in the UK, it's okay in the US. They have different meanings. The way they act here, it's kind of rude. Shows dominance on the left. Obama is kind of rude in other cultures. In the US, it means it's introvert. You don't sit this way in other cultures. In the US, it's okay. And in India and Bulgaria, you do this to say yes. You don't do that. They get confused. No, when you say yes. And when you wave your hand, it could mean no or goodbye. It's confusing. And when somebody smiles in the US, they're happy. But in other cultures like Japan, China, it could be I'm embarrassed. And this sign means okay, but it's rude in Argentina, Russia, and Turkey. Rubbing head is a no-no in many Asian countries, but in the US it means good job, you're doing good work. In other countries, you don't need to pay tip. In the US, you're required to give 50 to 20%. In the US, with your bosses, you're more or less treated equally, not in other cultures. The US, when you go out to eat, you pay for your own meal. Okay, now, verbal communication, how do you do it? Well, first, when somebody says, let's have lunch together, it means you pay for your lunch, okay? But Americans are a little quiet. Other cultures can be very rowdy and noisy. Americans use both direct and indirect language. For example, when Americans say, how are you? Say fine, even if you're not fine. In other cultures, you say, my father's sick, my mother's in bed, my children don't have money to go to school, they don't care. In the US, when you say yes, you mean yes. In other cultures, it could be no. When Americans say that's interesting, it means it's not interesting. When Americans say I'll think about it, it means no way, Jose. And chit-chat, bad topics, don't talk about sex, politics, and religion, and personal life. Okay, sports will be okay. Hi, please, thanks, and goodbye are important words in the US. In the US, you have to thank your parents and friends. That's weird for people from other cultures. You don't thank your parents. Slang, hey, yo, dude, what's up? This is how you greet people informally. There's standard English, New York English, Boston English, Italian American English, Southern English. There's Ebonics, there's Spanglish, there's Chinglish, there's English. And other societies, you should not disagree. In the US, it's okay to disagree. In the US, you blame others for mistakes. And in the US, you praise yourself for your success. It's different in other cultures. You have to use active voice in the US. In other cultures, it's rude to use active voice. In other cultures, 34 pages is one sentence. In the US, 2 pages can be one chapter. Do not do list. Number one. When you're with a friend, don't use your cell phone. That's very rude. That's my friend. It's illegal to threaten anyone. Call police if there's threat of bodily injury. It's illegal to hurt anyone. Call police if somebody actually hurts you. Seek help when you need it in the US. You can talk to your friends, your family. When you go home, don't just go on and on and on. Don't pretend you're American. Don't act you're better than everyone else. Don't be arrogant. Don't have a blanket hatred of the US. In conclusion, do not discriminate. In the US, don't discriminate. Women, people of color, people of lower caste, there's no caste in the US, it's illegal. Don't say my culture is best, don't say your culture is best. Rather say there are good things and bad things in your culture and in my culture. Be humble. Let other people praise you, don't praise yourself. Be fair, be happy, and be peaceful. Dankeschön. Merci. 谢谢你们。Sure. Thank you.